So hi guys, my name is Mansi Anand and I welcome you to this new session of RBI 24/7. So guys, before moving ahead with the session, I would like to wish you a very happy new year. So I hope that in this new year, we all follow the rule of work hard and party harder, right? So that means we have to study hard and after that we are free to party harder, right? So guys, I would like to ask you guys to subscribe to our channel. So if this is the first video of our channel that you are watching, then do not forget to hit the subscribe button. You can also press this bell icon to get notified whenever a new video comes up. You can also join our Telegram group. On this group, you can post all your doubts and queries and we'll try to get back to you as soon as possible. Right? So guys, in this session, we are going to discuss 5 questions which are about card transaction. So they have been picked up from various FAQs of the RBI website, right? So I hope you learn something new from this video. Moving ahead to question number 1. Okay, so this question says banks have been permitted to issue dash to natural persons having overdraft accounts so as to enable domestic digital transactions in such accounts, right? So guys, here you have to take care that this question talks about cards related to overdraft accounts, right? So moving ahead with the solution, correct option for this question is electronic cards. Just a second. Okay, correct option for this question is electronic cards, right? So guys, just as we have so many cards, so I hope that most of us on a daily basis we use different type of cards that are issued to us by either banks or other financial institutions, right? So before learning about this electronic card, let us first understand what is a card. In simple terms, a card is nothing but it is a piece of plastic, right? It is nothing but a piece of plastic, but with that card you can make so many uses, such as withdrawing money from the ATM or paying at your favorite shopping store or at a POS terminal, or apart from that you can also make online payments using your cards. So there are different types of cards which are issued by the central bank. Here we are going to discuss about 4 major types, right, which are debit cards, credit cards, prepaid cards and electronic cards. Debit card, in simple terms, it allows you to use whatever money you have in your account to make payments at various places. Credit cards, apart from using the money that you have in your account, it allows you to borrow some money from the financial institution that you can pay back later, obviously paying some interest on it, right? After that, prepaid cards. Guys, if you remember, we have discussed about prepaid cards in one of our previous videos where we discussed what are prepaid payment instruments. So there we discussed about prepaid payment instruments. So these are some cards in which there is already some loaded value. Basically, there is some value already which has been put up into this card. For example, let's say you go to Lifestyle a lot and you shop there a lot, and they provide you with a loyalty card that you can use, and whatever you purchase, whenever you purchase, you get some coupons on it or you get some points on it which are stored in your card, right? And you can use that particular card and those particular points stored in that card on your future purchases. So do you see, in this card there is some value which is loaded into that card, right? So those are like prepaid cards which come into the category of prepaid payment instruments. So if you have not watched this video, you can watch. In that we discuss the different types of PPIs or the prepaid payment instruments. After that, coming to electronic cards. Now what are electronic cards? Electronic cards are issued by financial institutions in connection to overdraft accounts. Here you can see, can be considered as debit cards. So basically they are a type of debit cards which are used in relation to specific overdraft accounts. Guys, I hope you are familiar with this account called overdraft account. We have discussed it in the session where we discussed about the credit card limit, cash credit and overdraft accounts that are maintained by banks. Basically this is an account which allows an account holder to borrow more than what is there in use an amount more than what is present in the account of the holder, right? So basically, let's say if 10,000 rupees are there in the account of the holder can use more than this in case of overdraft account, right? So in relation to those overdraft accounts, the debit cards which are issued by the financial institutions, they are known as electronic cards, right? That are in nature of personal loan, right? So these overdrafts are like loans that financial institutions, specifically banks, are giving to the account holders without any specific end use restriction. So there is no restriction on the usage of this money. The account holder can use this money for anything they want. Okay, after that, means the OD accounts where there is no restriction on the use of funds. They can be issued electronic cards, so they can make use of funds in that particular OD account, right? Okay, for all purposes like security, additional factor of authentication. So this term has already been discussed in one of our previous session when we discussed about QR codes and the usage of it. In that video, we discussed about additional factor of authentication. It is nothing but just an added layer of security. So for example, if you are making a payment on Myntra, you're shopping something from Myntra and you make a payment using your card, usually you have to put an OTP to to authorize that payment or to verify that it is the genuine account holder, that is you who is making the payment, not anyone else, right? So it is just an additional layer of verification or authentication. So for all purposes like security, AFA and merchant discount rate, also been discussed in one of our previous video. The instructions relating to debit cards are applicable on such electronic cards. So see, whatever guidelines are there for debit cards in connection to AFA or MDR, they are valid on electronic cards also, right? So I hope now you are clear with this. Here you can see the different ways in which cards can be used. A card can be dipped using a magnetic strip. Here you can see, a card can be swiped using magnetic strip. Basically, on card, there is a strip of magnet which is present. We are going to learn about it in this session further, right? You can swipe it by putting it in this. So basically, this is a POS machine, a machine which can read all the data which is present in the card. So this piece of plastic, this card contains some data about the account holder, right? So this data present on the card can be read by specific devices such as a POS machine. POS means point of sales. So guys, if you remember, we have already discussed the meaning of a point of sales terminal and a point of sales machine, how they can be used to read data, right? So in case of swiping, there is a little space present in the side of this machine and you can swipe the card there. And this machine is going to read all the data to help you to make the payment. Or you can use the method of dipping, in which you fix the card and then you have to enter a four digit PIN, right? And to verify that it is you who is making the payment or who is using the card. Otherwise, unless if your card is stolen, anyone can make a payment. But the PIN is kind of a security code that only you know. That is why it makes the payments safe. After that, coming to the part tapping. In this case, you do not have to swipe. You do not have to swipe the card or dip the card. You can just tap it, or you can just bring it near the reader, the machine which is going to read the data. So this is like a contactless mode of payment, because you just have to bring the card near the reader, the machine which is going to get or interpret all the data from your card, right? Here you can see, right? I hope this is clear. Moving ahead to the next question. Okay, so this is the second question for today, which says, which types of cards are allowed for withdrawing cash at POS terminals? So basically, there has been another facility which has been started. See, earlier, whenever we needed money, we used to go to ATM and use a card to withdraw money in cash, and then you can use this cash. You can use that cash, right? But here, it is not. There is an additional feature which is provided, that let's say if you are going to a shop to buy something and you need cash there, and if that shopkeeper has a POS terminal, so you can also withdraw some money using that POS terminal, right? So this question is in relation to that particular feature, that which type of cards are allowed to withdraw cash at POS terminal, right? So correct option for this question, moving ahead to the solution, option C. Option C means 2, 3 and 5 are the valid options. That means debit cards, open system prepaid cards and 5. Guys, don't get confused with this open system. I just told you we have learned about PPIs in a previous video. In that video, we discussed about the types of prepaid instruments, right? So if you're not aware of it, you can watch that particular video. That is going to help you. So the credit card cannot be used to withdraw money at a POS terminal at a merchant store. Closed system prepaid card can also not be used. The three types of cards that can be used are debit cards, open system prepaid cards and electronic cards. I hope you're clear with the meaning of each type of card. Okay. So cardholders can withdraw the cash using their debit cards and open system. Apart from that, credit cards cannot be used. Cash can also be withdrawn at POS terminal through UPI interface. So you can also make the use of UPI as well as through the use of electronic card. Right. So apart from using these three type of cards, you can also make the use of UPI to withdraw some cash at a POS terminal. Depending which store provides you with this facility. Okay. So under this facility, cardholder can withdraw cash up to 2000 per day in tier 3 to tier 4 centers, and at tier 1 and tier 2, the withdrawal limit is 1000 day per card, right? So these are some limits which have been put upon withdrawals from these facilities. Okay, third question. The third question says RBI has increased the limit for contactless card transactions and e-mandates for recurring transactions through cards and UPI from 2002 from January 1 to 2021. Basically here we are talking about the contactless card transactions. Guys, we have already learned about two types of transactions, card present transaction and card not present transaction. I think the name in itself tells you. See, card present transaction is a type of transaction where if you want to make a payment, it is necessary to be in possession of the card, right? So if you want to swipe it or if you want to dip it, you need to have your card physically. But let's say if you are making a payment at Myntra, you do not need your card physically. So if you remember the details, whatever there are in your card, you can make the payment using without physically using the card, right? So there is no need to have the card. You just need the details. So there are two types of transactions, card present and card not present. So basically here we are talking about contactless card transactions in which you just have to bring the card near the reader. You do not need to basically swipe or dip the card. In those cases, earlier there was a limit of 2000, but now that limit has been increased to option A, that is 5000, right? So this limit on these type of transactions in the form of contactless card transactions has been increased from 2000 to 5000 from January 1, 2021, right? Okay. So contactless transactions, for recurring transactions, for those type of transactions which are carried out after over regular intervals, like monthly transactions or daily transactions. So for those transactions also, this limit has been increased so that consumer convenience is enhanced while benefiting from the increased use of technology. They are well suited in the times of pandemic because your card does not make contact with any machine. There can be contactless modes of payments. So recent instructions on disablement of contactless feature on cards. So empowering customers to control the limits. Basically see, 5000 is the maximum limit. If you want, you can set a lower limit in order to protect any fraudulent activities, right? Because let's say if 5000 is the maximum limit, you have set up a limit of 2500. So if anyone tries to make a transaction of higher value than this limit, let's say of 4000, then you are going to get notified. The NIN transaction is not going to get an effect, right? So you will know that some fraudulent activity is going on. Okay, so to further the adoption of digital payments in safe and secure manner, it has been proposed to increase this limit, right? Moving ahead to the question 4 for today. Okay, this question mentions some statements about cash withdrawal facility at POS terminals as per RBI. You have to select the statements which are not correct, right? We have to select the statements which are incorrect. Moving ahead to the solution, correct option for this question is option E. Option E means 1, 2 and 3. That means all three statements are wrong, right? Let us try to correct them. Charges, if any, on these transactions, on these cash withdrawals, should not exceed 2% of the transaction amount for domestic funds transfer from one person to another, subject to prescribed limits. Guys, one important thing here, these cards can be used for domestic transactions by default, but if you want to use them in international transactions, you have to take approval from the banks, right? So this is not 1%, sorry, this is not 2%, the correct is 1%. So if there is any charge that is incurred on such a transaction, on whenever someone tries to withdraw money at a POS terminal, on that type of transaction, if there is any charge, the charge cannot exceed the limit of 1% of the transaction amount for the domestic funds transfer. So it has to be a domestic fund transfer and it has to follow the prescribed limits and conditions, right? So the correct answer is 1%. After that, cash can be withdrawn from POS terminals at designated merchant establishments only if the card issuer and the acquiring bank are same. So this is not correct. Guys, I hope you remember the different parties present in the transaction. So card issuer is the bank giving you the card. Let's say I go to Lifestyle and I make a payment and I have a card which has been issued by Bank of Baroda Bank. So in that case, Bank of Baroda is the issuer bank, right? And let's say the bank which has provided the merchant, the bank which has provided the merchant with a POS machine or which is allowing the merchant to receive payments is ICICI. So in this case, the ICICI bank, which is helping the merchant, who is the merchant here? The Lifestyle store. So ICICI bank allowing the Lifestyle store to make to receive the payments. So ICICI is the acquirer bank, right? So these are two types of banks. So basically, to avail this facility of cash withdrawal at a POS terminal, these issuer bank and the acquirer bank, they need not be same. They can be same, but it is not necessary. If they are different, then also the transaction can take place, right? So it is not necessary to have both the banks same. Last statement, I think it's getting a lot of, okay. Last statement says, facility is available only if the card holder makes a purchase from that merchant. So this is also not necessary. Even if you are not making a purchase, you can avail this facility. So even if I'm not shopping at Lifestyle and I want to use this facility, I can. But there might be some charges, as I told you in the first statement, right? So it is not necessary to make a purchase. That is why all three statements are wrong and we have corrected them. Okay, here you can see the correction of all the statements. Charge 1%. Cash can be withdrawn irrespective of the fact whether card issuer and acquiring bank are not same. Facility is available irrespective of a payment being made or not. Card holder can lodge grievance with his or her card issuer in case of any fraudulent activity or in case the transaction does not take place or in case there is any problem, the card holder can go to the card issuing bank. Okay, moving ahead to the last question for today. Here is the last question which says select the correct statement in relation to security of different payment technologies. Moving ahead to the solution, correct option for this question is option B. Option B means this one. So basically, there are different types of technology which are associated with different types of payment methods. So we learned about three types of payment methods: swiping, dipping, and tapping or the contactless payment, right? So swiping is made possible with the help of magnetic stripe cards, right? So magnetic stripe cards related to swiping, whereas dipping is related to EMV chips. EMV stands for Europay, MasterCard and Visa. The networks which allows different banks to connect with each other and make the transaction, right? So EMV chips and PIN technology is underlying the dipping process, and tapping is the NFC, that is near field communication contactless transaction. So guys, we have already learned about this NFC technology, that is near field communication, in one of our previous videos. If you're not aware of it, then you can ask for its link in the comments. Guys, see, it is very important to be aware of all these terms, because if I explain in detail all these terms, then the sessions are going to be really really long in duration. So that is why if there is any word that I say or it is written on the slide and you're not aware of it, then do ask for its meaning. If I say that it has been discussed and you're not aware of it, you can ask for its link and we'll provide you with the link, and then you can clear your doubts there, right? And even if you have any doubt after that, you can always mention them as comments on the video, preferably the latest video, right? Okay, here you can see, I think this picture is going to help you understand better. Here you can see magnetic strip card. So basically there is a strip, right? And this strip, whenever you swipe the card, you can go back to the picture. See, here you can see. So whenever you swipe the card, the magnetic strip that was present there is going to be read by the machine. So that magnetic strip helps you to swipe. And then there is a little chip that is present in this card that you can see here. That chip is connected with dipping. When you insert your card, then machine is able to read the data through this chip, right? So that is why I told you magnetic stripe, this type of technology is connected with swiping. See here, swiping, magnetic stripe, dipping, EMV chip and PIN. See, magnetic stripes were very popular in US, where the POS machine, it obviously reads the data with the help of this magnetic stripe. But in order to authenticate that the person who is making the transaction is the genuine account holder, they used to match up a signature, right? So magnetic strip card as well as the signature. So these are two types of associated technologies. Let me just write it here. Signature. Now coming to the next technology, EMV chip. So basically this is a chip. So these network providers, Europay, MasterCard, Visa, they came up with this. They were like the pioneers or beginners in this technology. That is why the chip is known with their name, right? So this yellow chip has the data, and whenever you dip it, the machine is able to read it, right? Now with this, they do not require signature. See, why do we need an additional layer of security? Because see, if this magnetic stripe was enough, then anyone who was in possession of your card could make a payment, and that would like increase, that would amplify the chances of fraudulent activities. That is why they have to make another layer of security. So in magnetic stripes, it was usually signature. In case of EMV chips, whenever you dip your card, they ask you for a 4-digit PIN. That is why this is called EMV chips and PIN technology, right? So EMV chip and PIN. So sometimes it might be possible that this EMV chip is paired up with signature. That means signature is the additional layer. But see, signature is not considered as a safe mode, because anyone can copy the signature, or many a times people do not match the signature exactly. The merchant who is receiving the payment does not match the signature properly. So see, PIN cannot be wrong. But let's say if someone is able to forge your signature, then this is not going to be safe. But yes, PIN, it is very difficult to guess someone's PIN unless and until the account holder tells some other party, right? So that is why this technology is considered safer as compared to magnetic stripe cards technology. Now coming to the tapping part, NFC technology, as I told you, discussed in detail in a previous video. NFC means near field communications, where you can make the payment just by bringing your card near the reader machine. You do not have to make the contact. So contact is not necessary, right? So this type of signal tells you that this technology is valid on the card, right? So magnetic stripe stores data on a magnetic strip present on the card. Data in EMV chip and PIN is stored in a chip. In contactless NFC card, the card is read by keeping the card near the reader, right? So these are three types of technology. So basically the magnetic one is considered to be less safer. EMV and contactless are considered to be much safer as compared to the magnetic strip cards. That is why the correct option in this question is question B. That means EMV chip and PIN card. So this is one, right? This is name of one technology. Then contactless NFC cards are considered to be safer when compared to magnetic stripe cards, right? So this was the last question. So guys, these were the five questions for today. I hope you learned something new from this video. And if you did, this video was beneficial to you, then do not forget to hit the like button. And I'll be back in next session with some new information. Till then, you guys keep watching, carry on your studies, and thank you for being here, and have a happy new year.